Korean game. On Hakka, they have a song called A Moi Moi Kim Nhan Ne Si Pa Soi Oi Ka Pi Ngai Ngai Moi. And then in Mandarin, we have Si Chi Pa Sui. So therefore, the 18 years old man, a lot. In Chinese, they said, 人见人爱,车见车在. It's a beautiful year. And here I have got to congratulate and wish Ma Seng on his 18th anniversary a fantastic year in 2012. Today, we will be talking about how good property can enhance your life, environmentology, which is Feng Shui. As you know, I lecture in China, in Jiao Tong University. And in Jiao Tong University, the university belongs to Communist China. They are very, very sensitive about the word Feng Shui. They say Feng Shui is a Chinese religion. Communists don't like religion. And over many years of study, they hunt for Hong Kong masters, Taiwan masters, Singapore masters, all over the world. And they finally decided to get a guy called David Koh to lecture in Jiao Tong University. First ever, not just for Malaysia, but first ever in the world to lecture in the university and conduct and draw a degree for them in Feng Shui. So if you want to learn Feng Shui and have a degree, not in Malaysia, come to China. And from then, they have insisted that I change the name Feng Shui to something else. Over much ado, we finally adopt, call the word environology. The word never appeared in any dictionary or in any encyclopedia. Very difficult to pronounce. And in Chinese, we call it 环境人文生态学. And ever since July last year, I add on another university called Tsinghua University in Beijing. And as of September this year, I will be also lecturing in one more university called the Suzhou University in China. So today, we shall see what we have got. First, we're talking about Feng Shui being a very ancient subject. In this ancient subject, modern living in ancient concept does it work? Were our ancestors smarter than us? They live on trees, they live on caves, or we are better? Let's take a look. Okay? We say modern living, ancient concepts in Chinese, were our ancestor right? There used to be a saying that people without history, we have no future. Talking about this, Charles Darwin's version of human being to Charles Darwin, it evolves from monkey. And God's version says, human being, God made human being. But somehow or other, when Mark Twain traveled around the world, he reached India. The Indian asked him, why did God create man? What is your answer? Why did God create all of us? Mark Twain said, God created man because he was fed up of monkeys. That's why you all are here. Are we from monkeys? I don't know. But ever since life evolved on this earth, everything else, not just human beings, even birds, even ants make their home. So therefore, the ants and birds also know Feng Shui. Anybody who want a roof and four walls to stay, live, we call that Feng Shui. It is a science, it's a knowledge, it's an art of how to create an environment for you to live in so that you are far, you are protected from sunshine, from rain, and also from enemy. And as we can see that, yes? And of all of them, bird was something very special, especially these birds. These are the finch. The finch, they make bird nests like that. If you ever go to the jungle, you will find a lot of these, some of these on the floor. Why they are on the floor? Finch are very much like human beings. Why? Because the male make the houses, not the ladies. The male make the houses. After they make the houses, they will invite their girlfriend to inspect. And their girlfriend will come, peck, 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 shake, 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 shake. If the nest fall, the girlfriend will not marry him. happy when he make a good nest like that, yes? So are we, yes? Men buy houses, but without a lady, you don't call it. Looking from villages to township, yes, these are the township that they make, you see? Look like township or not, yes? And from there, they have low-cost apartment like that, and then they got condominiums like that. You see, birds are like us. So when we make condominium, we thought we started it. No, the birds started earlier than us. They make condominiums, yes. Human dwelling, starting from trees, from caves, and evolves. We evolved from there into what we call the modern livings, where we are now living with. But before we go further, I'm requesting all of you, whatever concept you have in your brain, in your mind about Feng Shui, leave it one side first. Why? Because human brain behaves very much like parachutes. You know when you jump out into an aeroplane with parachute? How can you survive? You only survive if your mind is open. If your mind is closed, you will fall to your death. So therefore, please, for a while, open up your mind like a parachute and listen to what I have got to say, whether you agree or not. Tell me later. Okay, what is the world made of? We know that ever since we our primary school, our secondary school, we know the world is made of matter, it's our energy, and the space and time. Basically, that makes our three-dimensional or four-dimensional world. Everything in this world, as Einstein said, mass is a property of all energy, and energy is a property of all masses. All of us are masses, all of us carry energy. You see each other, you transmit energy to each other. So, a matter of frequency, some we can see, some we can't see. Some we can hear, some we cannot hear. Do you know that we can only see with our eyes between 440 nanometers to 800 nanometers. Anything beyond that, we can't see. We call it infrared, we call it ultraviolet. Who else can see all this with what we can't see? I tell you something can see. The dogs and the cats can see. You know when the dogs, in the night time, when they don't bark, but they howl, ooh, they saw something we didn't see. Do you want to have a pair of eyes like dogs? I tell you, they're all around us, there's so many things the dogs can see, we can't see. So therefore, what we can't see, what we can't hear, may not be non-existent, they are there. And we call that matter of energy and its frequency from audible to gamma ray. Yes. When we come back to buy property, there are basically only two considerations. One is whether you buy it for investment or you buy it for your own stay. Aren't we? So let's look into, because if you buy it for your own stay, then you got to have yourself as the point of reference. But when you want to buy for investment, you may think I don't need to. No, you need also Feng Shui. Why? Because the house that you buy, you may be renting to somebody. If there's somebody who rent your property, and if the property is a lousy property, the guy will go pokai. Right? He got no money to pay when you rental. So you must make sure he survive. Only he survive, he can pay the rental. So therefore, in both environment, we need to know. Feng Shui is a long, long old subject. They started calling Kanji, and then he called Qingwu, he called Qinglang, and he called eventually by the name called Feng Shui. Actually, I'm supposed to do this for 1.5 hours. Today they said you won't want to go back early. Why? Because you need a lucky draw. So I'm cutting a bit short. So I'm going to cut through this. This is the original Chinese compass. Yes, they call it Kanji. Why? Because in underneath vehicle, there are equipments, not compass, equipment, that they make in such a way that the guy stand there, the pen always pointing one direction, pointing at south. Why do they do that? Because during those time, ancient time, people go to war. Yeah, they don't have aeroplane, they don't have machine gun, what they do on horses, and they fight, and all the dust occupy the whole space, you can see yourself, you can see your enemy. So they need something to point. So the army know where to fight. And they always point at south. And eventually they develop a compass, they call it Nanzhen, meaning to say pointing south needle. So therefore, Chinese compass is pointing south, Western compass is pointing north. Why? Nothing special. You see, when you bend the iron on south, the compass points south. When you bend the iron in north, it points north. It's only where you bend the iron on it. It's actually the same. So from there, it evolved and evolved and evolved. A lot of people were arguing, Chinese Feng Shui come from where? Some say it come from America, some say it come from India. No, it come from China. It started, the base come from a book called I Ching, which is more than 6,000 years old. So we don't copy from nobody. In I Ching, you talk about three forces. You talk about cosmic force, you talk about earth force, and you talk about human force. When the three forces combine in unison, in harmony, you live in harmony. When the three forces are not in unison, not in harmony, you live in chaos. Tsunami is because cosmic force and earth force do not go in harmony. And that's why you got tsunami, that's why you got earthquake. When you and your wife quarrel, the two of you, your forces didn't agree. That's why you quarrel. When you agree, you won't quarrel, yes? So therefore, it came originally from a book called, everybody said, all the Feng Shui masters said, the original founder, the grandfather of Feng Shui is by this guy Guo Pu. In Guo Pu's book, it mentioned about, in Chinese, yes? Talking about energy forces because of gravitational force will move from high to low. And as a result, it will move and move until you reach a particular point that the energy cannot move anymore. What will stop these forces? Water, a different medium. That's why he said. Let's look into it and see what difference does it make. So in Feng Shui, we basically, or I basically, segregate it into two different main forces. One is what we call the macro, which is external. That means you're talking about landform, and this affects everybody. Whether you're old, you're young, you're male, you're female, never mind. They will affect you anyway. This is energy forces. It affects everybody. We call it macro. But the very moment you buy a property, you buy a house, you stay into the house, we call it micro. Why micro? Because there's somebody who lives in the house and the person is you. You become the center of reference. So we got to make sure we differentiate the two, macro and micro. This is what we are talking about. So let's go through these two very, very briefly on macro and on micro. First, we talk about cosmic forces. Yeah? On cosmic forces, we know we stay in this solar system. The solar system, there are 9 planets. Now they say maybe 10. Anyway, and we stay in this little blue dot here. That blue dot is where we live. All of us live there. Yes? Now what happened is, all the other planets are bigger than us. We know we learn from science, yeah? Any science that is bigger got a stronger pulling power. And because of this pulling, everybody want to pull us. How do we know? You know, the moon is smaller than the earth. So we pull the moon want to run away, we pull. So the guy keeps circulating us, cannot run anywhere else. But the same thing, all the other planets are bigger than us. So in the sky, we never move in a straight line. We play joget. If Jupiter pull us, we go this way. If Venus pull us, we pull that way. So we joke it in the sky. We never go in the straight line. Huh? This is why, and of course among them, we never leave the sun. He is the biggest of them all. He is a powerhouse. Without that, we won't be here. We are history. So we got to know all this. And therefore, that is on cosmic forces and cutting it short. The other one is earth forces. What are earth forces? Earth forces are mountains, rivers, roads, and all the forces on earth that is affecting all of us, which we don't see. For example, yeah? Our earth, we rotate on our own axis. Yes, every 24 hours, we go one round. But there's something very funny. We also tilted 23.5 degrees to one side. And every 365 years, we tilt back. Because of this tilting and tilting, we have then therefore, because it seems that the sun is moving, the sun didn't move, we move. Every time we tilt, one cycle is 365.2422 days. That makes our 1 year. When the sun is almost, when the sun, it looks as if in the southernmost part, we have winter in the northern hemisphere. When the sun moves upward, we have summer in our northern hemisphere. And then also we got gravitational magnetic force. This magnetic force is very important for our life because magnet determines our thinking. If your house the magnet is haywire, you cannot think straight. When you cannot think straight, you won't walk straight. Of course, you will be in trouble. So this is very important also. And of course, one other thing a lot of people do not know. You know, every morning you wake up, you brush your teeth, wash your face on the basin. It will fill up the water and you pull away the stopper. When the water goes down the downpipe, it turns left or turns right. And we wash face every morning. Never mind, we never notice it anyway. Tomorrow morning you watch, yes? Because the earth moves on west to east, yeah? West to east. So therefore, naturally, the water is a frictional force will go from east to west. Sounds reasonable. No, not true. Why? On the northern hemisphere, that is right. But in the southern hemisphere, it doesn't move like that. Southern hemisphere, it moves the reverse. That's why they call it the Coriolis force. I can believe this many, many years ago. Because a lot of Feng Shui masters from China, from Taiwan, from Malaysia, from Hong Kong, go to Australia, all become Waterloo. They koyak and come back. They did not know this. So when I first trip, when I went to Perth 15 years ago, I went to the bath, into the hotel, switch on to the bathtub, I fill up with water. My daughter asked me, "Hey Papa, you want to take bath?" No, I just want to see. I pull the stopper, see how the water go in. And therefore we know from there, that earth forces are that anything that is high, big, will always go downward. Isn't it true? That's why we cannot jump very far, right? We jump, we always come down on earth. So everything goes downward, then it goes sideways. So a mountain. 1 cubic meter of earth is 1 metric ton. That is science. If the mountain is 1,000 feet like Penang Hill, do you know how many billion, trillion tons of energy is going down and sideways? Plenty, plenty, plenty. And we'll keep on going, going, going non-stop until you clear Penang Hill. But Penang Hill is there. So the energy will continue. And you end up, you see all mountains like that. No mountains are straight line. No natural mountains are like that. And this is ripened. And all this energy on the earth that is moving, they don't move straight line either. They go in a vortex manner. Can you walk straight? No, none of us can walk straight. You draw a line, close your eyes and walk. You never walk straight. That's why a lot of people say Chinese everything crooked except the hair. No, even your hair also crooked. So therefore that caused why? Because as a result of which, when energy comes down and goes sideways, it got to transfer from solid to solid. For example, you can't feel. Why you can't feel? Because we got an empty space in front. The energy cannot transfer. If you come out on stage, at time, you can feel. That's why when the lorry move on the road, you stay in the house also, you feel it shaking because the energy is transferring. This transferring of energy is from solid to solid, meaning to say rigid to rigid. But when it comes to a point, or you come to river, or you come to sea, the energy will stop and bounce back. Just like our, when we make soundproof wall. When we make soundproof wall, we are double sleep with empty space in between. The sound from this side of the wall will hit the wall, and 90% will bounce back. A little bit will transfer to the wall, go to the void. And from the void, it transfers its vibration, and it goes to another wall. Again, 90% will hit back. Only another 10%, which is now 1%, hit the wall and transfer to the other side of the wall. That's why aeroplane got double slit window, so that the energy, the sound outside, you can't hear. That's why we call that, force transfer from rigid to digit, rigid. Yes, that's why in Chinese term, they say living energy moves in the vortex manner, only dead energy move in a straight line. Like snake, yeah? So living snake, like that. Dead snake go in a straight line. The Chinese, they say, 生气走起,死气走吃, meaning to say all living forces moves in a vortex manner. Only dead forces live in a straight manner. When you are alive, you also crooked, crooked. When you die, you go straight. That is what happened. Yes? So therefore, as a result, the moon of energy moves in such a manner, you see the mountain form like in that manner. and the mountain move in a snake-like manner. And because of this snake-like manner, Chinese call it, it looks like a dragon. Chinese are very funny people. They don't like any sound, anything that sounds bad, they will not say. When move like a snake, they say move like a dragon. When the mountain look like a chicken, they call it phoenix. Yes, when the platform look like a frog, they call it Chansu. So everything else must have a good name. And from there, they end up, head of Zhou Qinglong Yu Baifu. Heard of this? Zhou Qinglong Yu Baifu. Zhou Qinglong Yu Baifu. If a master come to your house, step in only tell you, Zhou Qinglong Yu Baifu. The Baifu said you cannot stay. If you stay tonight, the tiger will eat you up. It tells you one thing, the Feng Shui master do not know Feng Shui. Why? Because when you say this, there's a condition that you must be at back north, your south, your front is south. Then you say, Zhou Qinglong Yu Baifu, meaning to say north, east, south, west. Nothing very special. The jargon only frighten you as if the Feng Shui master is very knowledgeable. Actually, it's north, east, south, west. And this is what happened. They call it black tortoise la, they call it dragon la, they call it phoenix la, they call it tiger and all the other names. Actually, it means northeast, southwest. And this is a picture of how the mountains comes down and they go sideways and they travel until it meet the river. We can see the horses. But if you go to the desert, after a big sandstorm, after a very big sandstorm, you will see the natural formation like that. Where does the camel hide? The camel don't hide here. The camel will hide here, which is the embracing arm with the stomach holding it. Yeah? That's why the Chinese call what? Zuo san mian hai, huan san bao sui. This is what it means. Yeah? Okay. But it can also be magnified and shown on your body. We, our body itself, is already an encyclopedia of feng shui. If you know your body very well, you will then know feng shui very well like that. Yeah? Out of the 10 fingers, which is the strongest of the two? This one, click, 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 no, not strong. Only these two, right? Yeah? When you hold among these two fingers, which is the stronger one? The shorter one, yeah? Not the longer one. So when you look at, later on, I will show you the Penang map, Google map, you will see where are the longer arm and the shorter arm, yes? Okay. And if you look into the river, it's the same. If water in the river will move in that manner, in a vortex manner, as you move this manner, it will then erode all the land on the right hand side. And it will also take all the energy on the right hand side. And it will keep on spinning and spinning. But how long can it spin? It cannot spin 360 degrees. If it spins 360 degrees, the river will go in circle. Which is not true. Water by natural at 60 to 90 degrees, it will swing back. The vortex will instead of this area, it will swing back. As it swing back, whatever is collected over here will be thrown to both sides of the river bank, which then form up two sides of the embracing arm. And all natural river only go meandering in that manner, small or big. Anytime you see a straight river or a straight longkang, it's man-made. So therefore, when you see a straight river, man-made is wrong. Eh? Naturally, it must meander. This is what happened as we show you just now earlier on. Yes? So how to select the property? Condition number one, location. You got to see whether you are embracing arm or you are on the convex arm, for example. I give you an example of where the energy from of Malaysia come from. I give you an example. See whether this works or not. Yes? I do not know. Okay. Pum. Pum. Work or not? It doesn't work. Anyway, never mind. Then I skip this. If it doesn't work, I will skip this part of the story. No. Today, the one doesn't work. You see, actually, all the energy, whole world in the Northern Hemisphere, 90% of the Northern Hemisphere's energy comes from Mount Everest. Why not Mount Everest? Because there's the highest peak in the Northern Hemisphere. And you can see all the rivers all over, including Europe, all the river source come from Mount Everest. Two of them go to China, from Huanghe and Yangtze. Another one coming to... Thailand into Malaysia. Yes? And hence, anything that has got an embarrassing arm, according to Feng Shui Kopo, it is the best. We did a research. What research did we do? We researched 1,000 cities on the world and see whether all this natural form city conform to Feng Shui perspective or not, to share with you. Yes? One, this is Bangkok. Yeah? Bangkok. Bangkok is embraced by Chao Phraya River. Yes? It is like an eyeball looking on one side. It is all developed on the eastern side of Bangkok. When the western side of Bangkok come into development, after all they start making rivers. Because long, long time ago, Bangkok is called the Venice of the East. From one side of the river to the other side of the river, you need to go on boat. So after all the bridges being erected, the energy from the eastern side go to the west. And then the west begin to develop. Another city. This is another city, is Shanghai. Shanghai is embraced by Huangpu River, which is like Bangkok. One is on the left eyeball, one is on the right eyeball. But Huangpu has got another advantage because Suzhou River is actually form a confluence and hold the energy into one place. When the Putong all of a sudden come up, Putong did not come up until all the bridges are built and transfer all the energy from Puxi to Putong, from west to east. For those who have been to Shanghai, next time you take a cab, you ask a taxi driver, where do you stay? You happen to be one, I ask the taxi driver, where do you stay? He said, oh, very proudly, I stay in Puxi. I said, why you stay in Puxi? Putong is much more developed. He said, no, 宁要浦西一张床，不要浦东一栋房. He will sacrifice for a unit or just for a bed in Puxi. So, when is Putong going to be compatible to Puxi? Not over the next 20 to 50 years. The energy stay in Puxi. And of course, Hong Kong is another example. When China rented Hong Kong to British, what was Hong Kong like? Hong Kong was an island infested with pirates. There was no development. When did Hong Kong develop? Hong Kong developed because of Tianjin Matou. They made an underground tunnel from Kowloon to Hong Kong. All of a sudden, all the energy from China all pushed to Hong Kong. Hong Kong became one of the top four ports in the world. And look at Singapore. When Raffles found Singapore, the Sultan of Johor sell Singapore for $36,000. Only $36,000 of he sold Singapore. What was Singapore? Singapore was 50 fishermen village, 50 families only. When did Singapore become developed? Because we gave them a causeway. The causeway pushed all the energy from the whole peninsula of Malaya all the way to Johor Bahru, Johor Bahru to Shenton Way. Singapore developed from Shenton Way. And we quarrel. Finally, we give him another bridge in Jurong. And then we quarrel some more, we give him a curved bridge. Right, anyway, I used to say, and I say so much, I don't want to go to Singapore. Why? I say, Singapore, we don't need to quarrel with them, we just take all the bridge down, they go back to 50 fishermen village. What's so difficult? Okay. Penang. Yes? Penang look like what? Long Penang lang. Penang look like a turtle, right? You see, last time this turtle got head, you know. Because of development, we reclaim. Now Penang is a turtle without head. Hua bu lo liang. Chen ne liang. Right? You look at Penang, it look like a turtle with one leg, two legs, three legs, four legs. Those who do swimming, you know, yeah? You know when you do freestyle swimming? When the left hand go out, where is your strength? Your strength is on the right arm because this is where you got to pull, right? And that's why when the left leg of Penang go out or the turtle go out, the energy is on the right front leg. That's where Georgetown started long. Hanoi. Then after that, where is the next leg? That's where Madu Mong is all about. Yes? Coming. Now talking about it, remember or not, used to have a town here, a housing estate there, called Chai Ling Park. Heard of Chai Ling Park? When Chinese Park was built, there was no bridge. Chinese Park was nothing. People don't want Chinese Park. Chinese Park very cheap. Nobody there. But very moment the bridge is connected, wow, now Chinese Park become very expensive. Why? Because this turtle are very naughty. Like. So what happened is you tie up this turtle, so the turtle being tied up. When the turtle got tied up, the energy from Penang Hill and the mainland transfer to each other. And the energy is developed into Gelugo and into Chinese Park. Wow, both sides become very, very good. Now we want to, this turtle is still very naughty. No? We want to tie him up some more. So we tie up another one here next to the airport. Airport Tumong, we give him another rope, which is called the second bridge. And when the second bridge come up, because this place, Batu Mong, last time for many, many years, people don't want to go. But it's similar to this one. This is tied up. I tell you, Batu Mong is going to fly. We talk about Batu Mong later. Okay. The same thing like Kuala Lumpur. Kuala Lumpur started because this place formerly was go down. Go down for what? The ship from Klang come all the way to here to unload the tin. Kuala Lumpur. Earth. Tokomwe. Why Tokomwe? Because of all the tin from Ampang unloading here. Hong Kong, Shanghai Bank used to be a go down only. And because of that, they developed Kuala Lumpur begin here. Yap Aloy started here. And somehow we have something very special here. You know what is that? That's called Masjid Jamek. I got great respect for the ancient Malay Paji-Paji who developed the mosque. And end up, the Muslim control Malaya. Because that's one of the strongest energy force in the whole country. Yeah. To talk about that, I've been writing in the Star on Kuala Lumpur street by street. And this is starting from August 13, 2007 on part 1, landform principle, to last week, part 246 in June 22, 2012. Siakoni. Yeah. If you like these articles, go to Star Property online. Yes, all the properties are there. You go and download, you will be able to get. Yeah? So, how to select a property, we have said part 1. Part 2, again, still we talk about location. Why we talk about location? Let's look into Penang. This is Penang, right? Let's go Google Map and see what happened. Ah, you see now. How come all the people don't come and stay here? They all want to stay here. Huh? Why? Have you ever thought of that? A few reasons. One, Penang Mountain is right in the middle. Unlike any other place. Eh? Because of this, the energy will go both ways. Right? This side is facing the sea, it got storm. This side is facing mainland, no storm. Comes, number one. Number two, this side is facing east, that side is facing west. Facing east, the morning sun, you got germicidal effect, you will kill germs. On the afternoon sun, the sunlight is very harmful. Number three, this side got no pockets of the embracing arm. This side got plenty of pockets of the embracing arm. I will show you. Number four, you see, this arm already go to the front, no more strength. The strength is on this two leg already, you know. Because turtle don't jump like dog like that. Huh? Turtle have a free swim in a freestyle. That's what happened. I'll show you some more. Nah, you see? This is Georgetown, this is Butterworth. Let's go Google a bit further. You will be able to see. These are the embracing arm. Right now, your thumb and your big index finger. See this. This is the embracing arm. This is 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 embracing arm. And Batu Mong, this is also embracing arm. That side, we got a little bit here, but very steep slope. Here, got steep slope, but because of the sea. Let's go a bit deeper. We see, yes? Look at the embracing arm. You see that? There's a longer arm, there's a shorter arm. So Tanjung Bunga is a better arm. Shorter arm, yeah? Let's go another round, go further. Smaller, this is embracing arm. This is embracing arm. Longer arm, shorter arm. Shorter arm better. This is embracing arm. So whole of Penang West Coast got plenty embracing arm. Whole of, East Coast, whole of the East Coast are well developed. Let's go a little bit further. You see that? Can you see that? Can I? So when you want to buy property, go for embracing arm. You see, here you got endowment embracing arm. You know where is this? Masings bottom up. Yes. When the bridge is done, okay, the investment, the price will fly. The other side is Batu Pringgi. There is the embracing arm here. Masing have not launched a property, but they say you can register lah. And then when they launch, they will sell to you. But now they don't sell yet. Yes, because they don't get a license to advertise this yet. But watch out for that property. This property is very good for investment. Why? Because there's an international school there. When you're talking about silver hair, you're talking about second home, what do they think? They want the children to study. Where do they study? International school. This one has got an international school or not? Opposite Holiday Inn, right? And then there's a mountain right in front there, which is the forest reserve. Yeah, it is like living in the city but in the resort home. Fantastic place. Okay, this is the embracing arm I was talking about. Not only I talk good about Penang and South Bay, in KL I talk about South Bay. South Bay is one of the choice areas. Not 20 years ago, but now. Last time, Bolang Ai, why Bo Kyo Lai? No bridge to come. Okay. And this is what happened. And of course, there you see that? You see the embracing arm facing the sea? And of course, with an international airport, it's even better. Okay, and this is what it's all about. Yes? Okay. And of course, in the detail, here, still got embracing arm within the embracing arm. The one you want to know more, you got to engage me. I charge very cheap. For my thing, I charge you cheap. Okay. All right. And this is all the property and it's the pictures that they provide. Some of them are already fully developed and there are already people staying. The actual show bungalow in. Okay, so the basic principle in Feng Shui says face the river and face lowland. So long as behind you is taller, the front lower is considered good property. Where is the tallest part of Penang? Penang's tallest part is the Signal Hill, right? Right. Now, how high can you go and how low must you go? If Penang Hill is 2,000 feet, you remember the golden rule, architecture golden rule, the energy chakra is below 61.8%. If the top mountain is 1,000 feet, anything below 618 feet is good. Anything higher than 618 feet, watch out. Alright? Okay, in Feng Shui they say, Chen Yi Dao He Xing, Si Yi He Wang, meaning to say, city prosper because of road accessibility, township developed due to rivers. Is it true? Try me. You remember, there's a place in Tanjung Maling. Tanjung Maling, you know. Those people who, before the highway, there's a place called Tanjung Maling, north-south, you must go through, and all the buses, all the taxi will stop, including you and your family will stop there. Because Chen Yi Township developed, the city prosper because of road accessibility. Then they built the highway, Tanjung Maling, Kyo, Sidiao. The coffee shop also become no more. It tells us we need roads, we need rivers. And we talk about traffic flows. I don't know if you will notice or not. When you go to any row of shops, whether outside or inside a housing estate, always in a row of shops, two corners are either taken up by the banks or taken up by Kopitiam. Right? Now, on the two sides, it both the kopitiam. One side, the kopitiam do well, the other side, kopitiam don't do well. Why? This is a little tips. Next time you want to buy shop lot, on the corner lot, first check the traffic flow. If the traffic flow this way, that first shop is good. If the traffic flow this way, that shop is good. Now if the traffic flow this way, if you don't buy this one, you buy the last one, that's not so good. So therefore, because not so good, your resale value is not there, your rental, you don't get it there. If you operate the own kopitiam, you just like, why that guy Singli, you hope about Singli? You keep on wondering. Because you got to understand how energy flow. Okay, Feng Shui Ming Yan. The Feng Shui has got some very specific words. It says San Guan Zhen Ting Shui Guan Chai, meaning to say what? Mountain influences children and river influences wealth. Yeah? And of course, they also say Bao Shui Yu Qing Tai Yan Guan Jin Yi San Yu Si Ren Ting Xing Wang. If you got highland at the back and you got river and water in front of you, you not only your next generation will do well, you will also prosper after you shifted in. Yes? Okay. So external micro consideration, condition number one, location, condition number two, location, condition number three, still location. Is location, location, location. Wrong location, no good, yeah? Now, the last factor we're talking about that's concerning all of us is called human factor. Sandra, are you around? Sandra? No.
Sandra is it, but I am. What's up?
you got to give me signal when the time's up, huh? Because once I talk about Feng Shui, I will always overshoot. Huh?
Don't worry, we're still doing it.
You remind me when the time's up. Give me a signal, say 5-10 minutes, so that I know how to catch up.
Okay.
Now, on top of human factor, this is what you want. Why buy properties? We buy properties either for investment or we buy for our safety. Let's go further. Yeah? When you buy a property, it's just like buy a piece of mango. When you buy a piece of mango, you are thinking whether the inside is going to be so sweet like that. But when you open up, it becomes full of worms. Buying property is even worse. Because the developer sell you from drawing board, show you sample only. Like you wouldn't know what you're going to get. So you must learn a little bit of Feng Shui. What did the developer sell you? Oh, they sell you all this. They sell you the build-up. They sell you the building material. They sell you design. And they sell you the number of rooms and number of space. Is that what you want to buy? No, you buy something else. You want to buy for harmony. You want to buy for wealth. You want to buy for advancement. You want to buy for health. That's what you buy. Just like when you buy a car. You know when you buy a car, advertisement come up. Next to the car, stand a half-naked lady. What are you buying? You buy the car, you buy the half-naked lady. Then, even if you go to buy beer, next to the beer, it's always a half-naked lady. That is advertisement. But why did the developer say he didn't? Why didn't he tell you all this? He didn't tell you. Why? Because he do not know who is going to buy the property. They are mass production. They don't know who is going to buy. They don't know who is going to stay. So it's your job. It's your job to choose the right property. You choose it because of authority. You choose it because of harmony. You choose it because of advancement. You choose it because of health. Or you choose it because of wealth. You decide. They don't know. Yeah, so you cannot complain the developer didn't tell you this because you don't know who. So who can tell you this if the developer cannot? Feng Shui cannot. So therefore, you must look for Feng Shui. Because they do not know who is going to stay there. So therefore, now we talk about if you buy the property. Talking about it, when you buy a property, a commercial property and a household property, they're two different things. Commercial property, you got to consider what line of business you want to do. Buying a house is something you want to know. We only need to know when are you born. But commercial property, you got to know your business. This is an example. You know what this? This is Yu Cai Tiam, Chinese drugstore. You know why Chinese drugstore are like that? This has been for thousands of years. This is developed because of Lai Pu Yi. Heard of Lai Pu Yi or not? Lai Pu Yi is a very famous Feng Shui master. Long time ago, people wanted to start drugstore. and they don't know what to do, so they consulted Lai Pui. Lai Pui think for 3 days and three nights. Why did he got to think so carefully? Because he was thinking, if I make the drugstore business very good, the drugstore guy become very rich. What happened now? The whole town must be a lot of sick people now. Right? No sick people, how can the drugstore do good business? But if he were to make the drugstore pokai, also no good. Why? Drugstore pokai, all the whole town people got nobody to give the medicine. So you got to balance, a win-win partnership. What did he do? He designed his drugstore and with a concept. The concept is called Bai Niao Gui Chao Chu, meaning to say 100 birds going home. This pocket, drawer are like birds' nest. Yes. So the instruction given to the drugstore is every morning when you open your shop, you must, in the one that pounding on the drugs, you must take the abacus, and then open the drawer, open. What does it mean? It means you tell all the birds, you can now go out and cari makan. Night time when you want to close shop, what do you do? Same thing. There's no medicine inside, you know. Tell the bird, you can come home now. Open, close. So that the bird can come home and stay. You go out and cari makan every day, you come back stomach full. But after one night, you're hungry again. So every day cari makan, every day you can makan. One day you don't cari makan, you cannot makan. So end up, the drugstore people never get rich. Yo Chai Kiam Pei Hua Chai. But Yo Chai Kiam also never go pokai. That's only the pharmacy can go pokai, because pharmacy don't do this. Nowadays Yo Chai Kiam, why the current Yo Chai Kiam pokai? Because now the current Yo Chai Kiam not only sell drugs, they also sell rice, they also sell toys, they also sell what you name it, yeah? So therefore you must consider this, okay? Talking about this, give you another story. How many of you have heard of my talk before? Never, fantastic. I give you the story. You know, of all the people, who are the people who believe Feng Shui the most? The people so Pian Mui. Pian Mui, you know what Pian Mui is about? People who are gambler, people who are doing prostitution, these are the people who believe Feng Shui, habis. Why? Because they are not doing legal business. So that's why they believe Feng Shui to protect them. Like gangsters, they go to Thailand and bring all the Buddha on their body. The more you're doing illegal, the more you believe all this. So what happened? This is a story about a Bua Tao Kei wanting to start the casino. Other than getting architect and designer, he also get a Feng Shui master. So he tell all the architect and designer, you listen to the Feng Shui master, whatever you say, you listen, you know. So he asked the Feng Shui master, I want to start a casino, what design should I have? Well, the Feng Shui master, kira. And he said, I tell you, the best is to make the casino look like a crab. So he asked the Feng Shui master, crab was in your mouth. Very good. Because the crab walks sideways. So you just tell the architect, hey, listen to him, make my casino. Third step, we call matching. And fourth step, we call it energizing. Let's go through briefly, identification. Because when you want to stay in the house, you can identify who are you. Don't be like Jackie Chan, you don't know who are you, right? So you must know who are you. So we say, who are you? People born at different times, varies in character, so are building and spaces. No two persons are the same, don't know two spaces are the same. So therefore, we have got to know first, what? Who are you? By knowing who are you got to know your year of birth, or your month of birth. And to know that, you got to know when the year start and when the year end. When did the year start? Chinese New Year. No, Chinese New Year is a cultural New Year. Because for Malay New Year, Indian New Year, everybody, Christmas, all got New Year. So you cannot take New Year. Astronomically, Tianwenxue, astronomically, New Year starts during winter solstice. During winter solstice, the sun is the southernmost of the earth. On that day, the sun beginning to move northward. After 365 days, he go back again. That period is called 1 year. So this is a chart. You don't need to calculate, we give you a chart to follow. Very small. Cannot see, right? Give you a bigger one. then. But the trouble, we start from 1945 to 2012. Want to copy this? Very difficult. I tell you what, you copy this. I give you a way to copy. You copy that. You copy that one. You copy WW means web. You copy that one, go to our net, our website. Our website is at FOC, the website, Oshuruye. You go in, punch in your date of birth, we will tell you what gua you belong to, what sort of door you must select. What I'm talking to you today, it all appear on the website, FOC. The word O-R-G tells you we are a non-profit body. After you benefited from it, you want to do a donation, thank you very much. If you don't want to do donation, never mind. Sandula. Right, okay, copy already. If you want my name card, after you come forward, I give you my name card. Yes, whichever you want, okay. So after knowing your number, this is where you find number. For example, 1984, a male is called Kua 7, a female is called Kua 8. Tapo si te chi kua, tao si te pe kua. You know why the Chinese call the lady Pakua? This is where it come from lah, Pakua, Pakua. Come from here lah. Yeah? Alright. And you don't need to copy this, go to the website and do it, okay? And from there, you will then will tell you what element you are. You with the five elements, whether you are wood, you are fire, you are earth. And they will teach you all this. Then you know which one contrasts who, which one produces who. I don't explain too much, go to the net, we'll teach you all this. This is called identification. Not only we identify you, you got to identify the house by sectors. How do you identify the house by sectors? We want to identify which part of the house based on your kua is the wealth sector, where is the health sector, where is the advancement sector, where is the harmony sector. In every house or any house, there are four good sectors, there are four bad sectors. What are the bad sectors? The bad sectors are these. Oh, very scary, right? No, don't get worried about all this. Because these are the new terminology I translate. This one, I didn't want to translate, you know why? Want to scare you. Pakyarulo. You know why the ancient Chinese masters are very, very merciful? In ancient time, 95% of the Chinese are illiterate. Mbatsye. The Mbatsye long chong chong kwa all become ministers and Feng Shui master. So when this Feng Shui master come to this old lady's house, who is illiterate, Mbatsye, and talk to her that your kitchen cannot be here, this on Jupiter like that, the sun like that, the gravity like that. Did the old lady understand? Old lady don't understand. All you need to do is tell the old lady, your kitchen here, this place got five ghosts. My like, now she will shift. So this is the kindness of the ancient Feng Shui masters to scare you that you don't use this. Doesn't mean that your door is at five ghosts, there will be five ghosts waiting for you. No, yeah? It means that it's a bad door. Right? If the door is a death door, doesn't mean you will die. No, it means that you will meet a lot of accidents. Right? That is what I mean. Doesn't mean you will die. So don't take this seriously, but don't also take it for granted. Okay, so this is what we give now. We then now plug, redesign it, and make it, for example, you are Guangwan. A Guangwan people, the north sector is advancement, the east sector is health, the southeast sector is wealth, the south sector is wealth. Yes? So there are total of 8 Gua. The people are divided into 8 groups, or life profile into 8 groups, and these are the 8 groups. Gua 1, Gua 2, Gua 3, Gua 4, Gua 6, Gua 7, Gua 8, Gua 9. All have got the thing plugged in. Now how do you know North, East, South, West? Okay, now come to selection. How do you select? To do selection, the first thing you must understand is you are not going to be a practitioner. So you need to simply understand there are only 3 major and 6 minor. 3 major and 6 minor. In Feng Shui, we call San Yao Liu Si. The 3 major is you need to know the main entrance, you need to know the bedroom, you need to know the kitchen. The minor, the former last time they have different minor. Why? Because last time their toilet is outside the house. Their well is inside the house. Their rice, they got to grind themselves. So these are ancient times. Modern, we change it, because now what happened is, instead of having the toilet outside your house, not only you bring it into your house, you bring the toilet to your master bedroom. After the toilet comes into the master bedroom, you look for Feng Shui master. Hey master, my toilet in the bedroom, how? Look at it, right? So anyway, let's go through this. First point of reference. The house owner, the guy who stay in the house, not the ownership of the house. The guy who stay in the owner who stay in the house is the point of reference, number one. But in the house, when we talk about the eighth sector, you also must point the point of reference. Where is the point of reference? The center of the house. Why? Because if you stand here, the north, east, south, west is not the same. If you stand here, this is north. But if you stand here, that is northeast, right? And you cannot stand at the door. Because you stand at the door said north. You say, I want northeast. So you tip. So your door becomes slanted door. Because the point that you stand is wrong. The point that reference you get is wrong. How do you get this right? You take the longest and you take the deepest. Cross, the point that you cross is the center of the house. Yes? Meaning to say, you don't take up to here, no, you're gonna take up all the way and all the way, yeah? To find the center of the house. After you get the center of the house, what do? Go and get a compass. You don't need our compass. Our professional compass, very expensive. Huh? After all, so many levels, you also don't know. Huh? Cannot read. Huh? Just go hardware shop, get a $20, 20 ringgit compass will do. But all you need to know is north, south, west. Right? So, you go to the center of the house, cross, take the compass, get a wooden chair or plastic chair. Put the compass there and look where is the needle, north and south. Because the north-south needle is natural. You cannot change the north-south. Once the needle is there, it's there. Let's say the needle is here, no. This is north, that is south. If the door is here, this is north, this is south. If the door is here, where is the door? North, south. If the door is here, it's what? East door, yeah? So your house is having an east door. Not where the door is facing, the door don't face anywhere. It's the door is in one sector. In this case, the north is here, the south is here. Where is the door? The door is in the south sector. You understand? Balik? Yeah? So next time don't say, where is my door facing? The door don't face anywhere. It's a sector of the door. Like this. And if the door, if this is north, this is south, where is your door? Your door is in the southwest sector. That selection must be done first. After that, this is the main entrance. Why for mentioning door? Why can't we use a window? Why can't we use a chimney? The chimney is where the Santa Claus comes in. Yes? The window is where the butterfly and birds come in. You see, we human is a static energy. As we walk in and out of the door, we carry and translate the energy outside and inside to an equilibrium. Outside energy is always bigger than the house, inside the house. As you walk in and out, the energy will be transferred in and out and it finds its equilibrium. Will it ever find an equilibrium? Never, because outside the energy is always larger than the house. Always. So, you want to know whether your house is right or wrong, right? Simple, eh? Go and take a tissue paper, cut it very, very thin, paste it here, put it at the door here. Under no wind condition, if the tissue paper flow inward, meaning to say energy, zip line, if the tissue paper flow outward, it tells you the energy is going outward. So you want to know your house is positive or negative? Very easy, ma. Go and test it out too. Go home and test it. Okay. So why, when we talk about the door, who takes the door? Because you got a male gua, you got a female gua. In a house, so many people. Eight people, eight different gua. You cannot have eight doors, you know. Right? You only one door, ma. Who takes the door? The man takes the door. Man takes the external. Lady takes the balance all. Yeah, so men buy the house, lady make the home. Yeah, the man after taking his squat, look at the door, after the door, he is jobless. bo ye tai chi liao. The kitchen, the bedroom, everything else go to the wife. Yeah? Now in the house of many, many men, which man do you take? Which man do you take? The eldest working member male. If you stay with your father is still working, take your father. If your father is not working, you take. If you stay with your mother is not working, your wife take. If your mother is still working, your mother will take. Yes? All the balance of the children, how do you calculate them? Male and male, female, female, we come to that later. Yeah. The door, therefore, you see, it's like tomato ketchup. You buy a full tomato ketchup, you put new one, not full, you poke, never come out. You take a chopstick, you poke, you come out. Yeah? So you are like the chopstick of the house. You walk in and out, you bring the tomato ketchup in and out. Yeah? And this, of course, in our case, I have developed not just ordinary compass, I've developed into a binary compass. You don't need to learn I Ching from me, you don't need to learn all the complicated things. We give you a binary 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 compass. All you need to do is you know the A to Z, 26 alphabet, you know 0 to 9. You can learn Feng Shui from us. Yes. This is the old Chinese ancient compass, and this is the daily code compass. So therefore, you don't need Malay, Chinese, anybody. So long as you know what this number, we'll teach you. Yeah? If you want to learn, you can. Last month, I just conducted a diploma course for Penang, Persatuan Architect Malaysia, Penang chapter. We just completed last month in Penang. 99% of them are banana. You know what banana is? Yes, banana, yeah? Yellow outside, white inside, yeah? Now we don't call them banana, very, very insulting. We call them OCBC. Yeah, you know what's OCBC? Orang Cina, bukan Cina. Now the OCBC can learn all this. On top of that, the Indian friend, Malay friends. I got a lot of Malay students. I got a lot of Indian students. I conduct courses in Australia. I conduct courses in Indonesia. I conduct courses in Vietnam. I conduct them in Thailand. I don't speak Vietnamese, but I talk to them 1, 2, 3, 4. I speak some Thai, then some I can, yes? I speak pretty good Thai, okay? So, after knowing your identification, you do your selection. Once your selection is done, you need matching. Why do you need matching? Because the developer, your head is in the north. As the blood circulate, all the iron got deposited in the north in your head. Over a period of time, you will have stroke. Or you will have bad dreams. Because blockage. But if the other way around, if your leg is in the north, what happened? And the magnet don't care, no leg or head, no. Anything north, they're direct, no. So all of a sudden, if your leg is in the north, all the iron goes to your leg. Yes? How do you know it's bad? Simple. After sleeping your leg on the north for 3 nights, you wake up in the morning, you stand on your heel. Don't stand on your toe, huh? Stand on your heel. If your heel pain, feel painful, it tells you what? Uric acid, all the other gout, whatnot, deposited on the leg. So therefore, you cannot sleep on the north-south. Where should you sleep? East-west. Why east-west? The Creator made your heart on one side, on the left. If not, the heart will be in the middle. Now your heart is on the left. If you sleep and having the north on this side, where the heart is situated, iron still pull, no? The iron all deposited on the left side of the heart. Then you feel uncomfortable. Then you turn on night time, then it pulls back. So one night, you can keep on turning 20, 30, 50 times, you still sleep well. But if you sleep in the north south, you know what you're going to do? You're going to do somersault. What else can you do? So my recommendation is you sleep on the east-west orientation, east or west. If you are a western group, sleep in the west. If you are an eastern group, sleep in the east. This is how you place them. A lot of people are very concerned about toilet. The toilet in the master bedroom, okay. The one concern is this one, the toilet bowl. Because the toilet bowl, after you do your business, you flush, man. As you flush, the pulling power is very, very powerful. So long as the toilet bowl do not sit on the good area. How do you know it's not good area? In the toilet here, do another 9 segment. Whichever the bad segment, put the toilet bowl. Good sector, don't put toilet bowl like this. Yeah? Give you an example, yeah? Like that. So long as the toilet bowl sits on the bad sector, okay. Good sector, don't sit. Sounds very difficult. No, huh? Alright. The other you got to observe, there are many, many things. Huh? From main entrance to space utilization to golden rule proportion to sharp acute angle, space height, front door, back door, overhead, or so many details. I don't think I can go through one by one next time, nah, or else. Anyway, on July the 13th, 14th, Star Property Fair in Penang, I'll be here again speaking on Masing. Then I'll have more time. I will explain a lot more on this. Yes? Yeah. Golden rule. I don't think I have time today for the golden rule. MC, yeah. How much time I got? MC? Where is my MC? Well, what time now? Tell me. 5. Oh, no time already. Lucky draw. Like. I know. This one next time. We got lucky draw coming. I know. This one cut. I mean, this is a golden rule. Very pretty. These are against golden rule, not pretty. Next time, yeah? The Chinese, we call this in Feng Shui, meaning to say, needle point space. Again, I don't have time to explain, I'll skip this. This is golden rule proportion. How do you, in the house, energize to get whatever you want? Because the energy move in a manner called the golden rule line. And this is why the golden rule proportion, most of the houses we consult, we do consultation, we do the line for them, and we tell them what to place on the line so that they will get the out of it, and the effect is fantabulous, immediate. Okay. And this is one of the buildings in Kuala Lumpur that we have designed 100% on golden rule, and it's an old folk day care center. Next time I talk about this, okay? So this is what golden rule proportion is all about. One thing I like, why I stand for Masing property. The Masing property is internal spaces. Their bedroom, their everything else, the space, are all golden rule proportion compliances. Houses without golden rule proportion will have, the energy will extinguish. Only houses with golden rule proportion, the energy will be forever growing. That's why it's so special. That's what I like about Masing's design. Okay. But there are so many other details, from staircase to missing area to kitchen to stove to toilet, fish pond, aquarium, one waste disposal, drains and pipe, paint, colors, and blah blah blah. There are so much of them. Next time, So, other minor details, even more than that. Plenty. There are 3 days, I can stand here 3 days. Okay. Again, come back. Why do you buy a property? For self-stay or for investment, buy and sell or rental. All need to have property. A lot of you people already know, I also buy a property from Masing in MCT. Not only I thought they are good, to prove to you it's good, I bought one. Yes. Anyway, these are our KL property. These are the hanging gardens at the MCT in Kuala Lumpur. So external, we can talk about location. Internal, we talk about position. About the same, but it's the orientation and the position. What is not Feng Shui? Feng Shui got nothing to do with cultural practice. Cultural practice varies from one culture to another. Chinese New Year is a cultural practice. Religion is between you and God. Feng Shui has got nothing to do with religion, so therefore I can prove to you all the ancient texts, never in Chinese ancient Feng Shui texts ever mentioned you need religion, never ever mentioned you need cultural practice. We talk about environmentology, which is in itself a science. These are cultural practice, these are religious practice. Yeah? To hang a mirror in front of your house, they say, what do they say? What the mirror can do? The mirror will reflect ghosts, that energy. Right? Is it true? The mirror doesn't read. The mirror got no brain. If the mirror can reflect good energy, the mirror also can reflect good. If the mirror can chase ghosts away, the mirror also can chase God away. So mirror got no brain. A lot of people like to have bell. You know what a bell used for? In China, even now in Malaysia, bell is meant not to invite wealth. Bell is to talk to dead people. You know Sai Kong, when someone died, the Sai Kong will tang, 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 tang. He tell the dead guy, tang, 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 follow me, I bring you to the new house. That is the bell it's all about. But of course, in Malaysia, we also use a bell to do another thing. To do what? Sell ice cream. Yeah. The bell has got nothing to do with Feng Shui. So are the frogs. The living frog also useless. Don't talk about dead frog. Why a frog bo yong? See a frog so me quick. Anyway. Now, we're talking about that. Every home, a masterpiece in Masing, we are talking about how good property can enhance your life on environmentology from Masing with that eye.